thank you so much for your time today on the show, Moses. And what we've seen playing out here today, we've seen the financial stocks up almost 1.8%, close to 2% today. What's your take on what's playing out? Also, kindly speak to what we're seeing play out with Access Bank, with that acquisition story we're hearing from the SA-based Grow Bank.
Okay, so I think so far the market this week, and even last week, you noticed market gained about 2.17% last week. And this week, we're opening the week on a positive note as well. I think after that, the MPC meeting, and the MPC kept your rate at 11.5%, it sent that signal to the market that rates are likely going to stop increasing in any time, suggests that central bank is still dovish. And on the back of that, investors are positive about the equities market. And those that have been thinking that yields will continue to increase in the fixed income space have to think twice. So on the back of that, we saw improvement in sentiment in the market. And to capture that, we've seen some decent results in the market, which has been driving sentiments in major names, even GTB, if you look at what Daxen did last week as well. So all these have actually been improving sentiment in the market. And for Access Bank, it's just in line with the bank's strategy to become Africa's gateway to the world. And if this is to cap, in addition to what they did last year, around this time last year, they acquired a Kenyan bank, transnational bank to be precise. And this is just in line with the bank's strategy to expose to be exposed to other African countries.
All right, you talked about earnings earlier. We're looking at some names that came out last week, Dangote Cement being one of the few that kind of moved the market last week. But I'd like you to speak to what we're seeing play out in earnings and, you know, how investors positioning, especially with the results that we're seeing play out. And for some of the big names that were still to expect, what are you guys calling out for that?
So for the results so far, like you said, Dangote is particularly very good. And Stanbic also surprised the market with that the massive dividend pay. Declaration, and on the back of that, investor sentiments also went to that stock last week, and we are seeing also sentiment in GTB as well. I think we are now getting towards the end of the earnings season. It's just we are just waiting for the audited result for First Bank and then Boa Cement, as well as audited result for Access Bank. So I think apart from these are the three major names that we are yet to see in the market. But generally, it has been very good. If you look at dividend declaration of these names, some of them still have decent dividend yield. Even if you compare it to yields in the fixed income space, but tell you if you are investing for 1 year and you compare it, you still see that it's still decent. And with the rising inflation figure that we have been seeing, investors will continue to look at the equities market and see where they can get a positive return on their portfolio.
But let's talk about participation in the markets. First, looking at the domestic side of things and how we're seeing also foreign players playing the markets.
I think so far, the market has still been dominated by local players. If you check the most recent data from NSE, it's showing that locals are still the one playing out in the market. And if you look at the trend in the INA window, there's something to suggest that there's massive inflow from FPI into the market. So on the back of that, we can still guess that this, based on the available data today, it's still locals that are still dominating the market. But this is not to say that we are not noticing. We've noticed a little bit of improvement in FPI inflow, but it's still far below what it used to be. And it's still early to say these monies are coming to the equities market. But we'll continue to track that and see whether it's locals that are still playing up or the foreigners that are the ones coming to our market to pick up these names.
Right, but what about dividend payments? And how much is that influencing investors into some of the sectors that we're seeing here? And when you look at how these sectors have performed so far, which are your top picks for this going into this week?
I think in terms of dividend payment, it's quite decent. Like I said, Stanbic surprised the market with that dividend payout, I think around over 3 naira or so. And that is still surprising to the market. If you check their history, I'm not sure they paid up to that. And on the back of it, like I added to Zenith, what Zenith also did in terms of dividend pay, final dividend of 270 kobo, same thing GTB. So all these actually supported sentiments in the market, and Dangote also paying 16 naira for the stock. So I think if you put all this together, dividend yield on the average are well above 7% or so. If you compare some of these names and compare it to 1 year bill, you get a 1 year bill. I think it's quite decent, and investors are reacting positively to that. And generally, I can say the result has been quite good for most names, except the oil and gas players, as well as the consumer goods and beauty space that we have seen weak result.